rig Project Zero. Interested to mention that this ended up in the bin. This is nothing to do with the package I'm just opening. It's something I bought because I do carry a lot of things around and it ended up in the bin. Fibrofog, fibromyalgia, fibro effect in the head. Take your pick, but it often happens. So, after the pregnant pulls, here is something that I tried to substitute for something else, something cheaper, several times, and I just ended up coming back to the same thing. And although I nearly ended up with something made by Steel Series in the same store I just picked this up, purely because they had it in stock, I just couldn't bring myself to go for something. Other than that, I decided to do two jobs very well. This will last. This is made like a tank. This is professional. And this won't go wrong. It needs me to buy a whole new one. Oops. And there's something came with it. This is, as I've mentioned on the blog several times, there's a little tipple. When I say tipple, that's Vimto, made famous by the English comedy series. Lager and a packet of crisps. And here, finally at an end, is me debating whether to go for something else. Strange, I saw this in a group test in Micromart recently where they said things nobody else has ever said about it. Micromart is not really seen as a gaming magazine. But they do include a lot of gaming stuff. But I've seen a lot of people in America that do reviews of products to do with gaming have actually ended up substituting a Razer keyboard with this after using it. They said they was that impressed. They was keeping it and it was becoming their keyboard. There is bigger, it probably is better, and there is a lot more expensive. In fact, there's something well over £100 more expensive than this. The Mad Cat's Strike 7, which looks very nice, but it isn't a mechanical keyboard. Pretty as it is, it's way too expensive. So I'm doing this little unboxing. This is, if you didn't notice on the box, is a Corsair Vengeance K70 mechanical gaming keyboard. And I've taken the unlikely dive into wired peripherals, which I'm rather surprised. Some things they still seem to stick to. Taking it out confused me when I first started looking at this, because I came across a lot of pictures which I thought was an older version, because there was something about this that really caught my attention. Now, there's a little instruction thing. There's the wire. There's the wrist rest. I believe that's all. So I can take that and shove it in a pile of crap, which normally builds up until I find the energy to deal with it. Now, what was confusing about this was that whenever I saw this in pictures to see who had it and how much they were charging, I then thought they were actually selling a different model, because it looked exactly like this one. And you'd be thinking, forgiven for thinking, boy, that man's lost the plot. It looked just like that in the pictures, but he thought it was a different model. And that's because one of the things that you get on this keyboard, other than the fact it's nylon splash proof and everything else, Oh god, I've missed keys like that. I have not touched a keyboard like that in a very long time. Oh hello. Can you believe it? It's damaged. I have lost count, ladies and gentlemen, of the number of times I've bought something in the UK and it's ended up being a refurbished item. And they don't even seem to bother covering it up. Almost as if they've got carte blanche and been guaranteed that there'll never be any comebacks to it. I've had it with Argus, 5 cameras on the trot. I then gave up, got my money back and went and bought a camera, which I'm using right now, Sony Cybershot, after 2-3 Nikons and Olympus. And I went to PC World. Now this has come from PC World. And I don't know if you can see, but I've noticed it almost immediately, right there, where that scrolling thing is, there's a lift. That is definitely not meant to be like that, because there's a gap at the back. Right. That's been dropped, and that lip there has landed on something and it's put a dent. Right, and I just see it, when I see these, I just think one or two things is happening, right, with the companies in the UK. I've had it with Shop Direct, the own Littlewoods catalogue and Very catalogue. They lost a court battle with me where they tried to screw me for money for something that weren't worth a tenth of what they wanted for it. In fact, it wasn't even worth that. And lots of people seem to think that they just got the courts and the law and everything in there. You know, they're doing illegal, horrible, evil things. And they seem to think they have a right to do it and the law's there to protect them. Doing it. So I'm going to have to email PC World and have a go at them. After having several goes at Amazon, just kind of believe this is happening. Now one or two things is happening. Either, and I can't believe, here I am filming an unboxing I've been waiting weeks to get, and it's damaged. Now either, stupid customers are buying these things. Here's a key here. That's for taking off the keys. Here in the box are these little red keys. Push on like that. That you replace several keys with. The idea being, these light up, which I'll do another film of, another thing. You see underneath there, there's a little mechanical pressy thing, which is a Cherry MX switch, and the little LED light, which will light up red, because this is backlit. Because I've also got fed up, don't understand why backlit, why all keyboards aren't backlit, because I've lost count of the number of keys, keyboards I've had where the letters rub off, either on laptops or separate keys, even on some of the most decent Logitech ones, and I've become rather fed up with it. Another thing is, because I have these orchids, they don't really like lights on in the evening. If I'm playing late, I can't see the keys, and I end up having a light on. So, when I saw this keyboard, these keys from 0 to 6 are convex like that. They go up like that. So you can actually feel them in the dark. You can, your fingers will pick them out after a time. You will just pick up and get the feel for them. Oops. That didn't go too well. And here I'm just showing you me changing them and explaining that when I first saw this keyboard in pictures, see that's got a convex shape there. This was why I got confused and thought they were still in an older version. I didn't realise that. Oops. You could the actually put on by the people, or Corsair, or the people that were taking the picture. Here's number six. So 1-6 at the top, which is often used for, if we're playing games, you know, they're often used as a weapon selection keys. There's a W, and the WASD, WASD keys, are used for moving around in a game world. And that one is tilted that way. So they're sort of odd shaped on the top, designed for you to sort of feel them in the dark without looking. But if you need to look, roll it up. So there you go, there's an unboxing. A little film of me putting on the keys. We're missing in some pictures, made me think some people were selling an older model. And I'm now going to go and test to see that the what it's like in some of my games after I've actually put the wrist rest on. Ooh, how do you do that? Easy enough. And there's an unboxing of a very nice keyboard.